There are two main reasons why we provide oncoplastic surgery. Even though it is a bigger surgery, there are two main benefits that we have. One is better cancer removal by removing wider area of normal tissue surrounding the margin of the cancer, so that we know that this will give us a better chance at complete removal of cancer to prevent cancer recurrence and reoperation. The second major benefit of having oncoplastic surgery is improved cosmesis and patient satisfaction. Sometimes lumpectomy can cause asymmetry of the breast, deformity of the breast, and obviously that can result in low self-esteem and sense of being damaged as a result of breast cancer. And oncoplastic surgery can provide reconstruction at the same time to prevent such a deformity and perhaps better sense of self and improved quality of life.
Essentially, oncoplastic surgery means any kind of plastic surgery to address a cancer problem. But in this case, we use it to mean reconstructing the breast after part of it has been removed with lumpectomy to treat cancer. And we usually work as a team with the surgical oncologist and the plastic surgeon in the operating room together. And this is a joint effort to allow the breast that's remaining after the lumpectomy to be reshaped and lifted. And we usually do that through a scar pattern that's very similar to what we do in aesthetic surgery to lift or reduce breast size. And there are a variety of different patterns that can be used. Some go around the central part of the breast and between that and the fold under the breast. Others also include the fold under the breast.
A good candidate for oncoplastic surgery would be somebody who is a good candidate for breast-saving operation. Sometimes lumpectomy can be small and can be done with minimal change to the breast, but sometimes lumpectomy requires large amount of breast tissue removal, and therefore the patient will be at risk for significant noticeable deformity or size asymmetry from one side to the other. So patients who have to have a larger lumpectomy, first of all, would be more of a good candidate for oncoplastic surgery. So oncoplastic surgery is done usually together. Breast surgeon who will do the cancer part of the operation, and my goal would be to remove all of the cancer with a margin of normal tissue to make sure I got all of the cancer out. And depending on the diagnosis, I will also do sentinel lymph node biopsy or other types of lymph node removal may be done during that same operation. And then in the same operation, as soon as I'm done, the plastic surgeon will be there to reconstruct the breast, usually with just natural tissue of the patient, to shape the breast in a nice way and symmetrize the other side at the same time.
Well, when we are doing plastic surgery to help fill in a lumpectomy cavity, we are taking advantage of the body's own tissue that remains in the area. By extending incisions, we are able to release some of the remaining breast tissue, and we're able to move it around to maybe lift it up so that the footprint of the breast on the chest or abdominal wall is higher, closer to the higher point on the breast wall. And by doing that, and possibly tightening skin as well, we are able to use what was left of the breast to help reshape the breast. And then we also are trying to match to the opposite side, so we may do a similar procedure on the other side. So I think the real benefit to an oncoplastic surgical procedure is, one, it may help decrease future problems in terms of shape and appearance of the breast, it may also help the surgical oncologist be able to be a little bit more aggressive, take a little bit more tissue when they do their lumpectomy, which may expand the ability to do lumpectomies to more patients who may not want to consider a mastectomy, but without oncoplastic surgery, may be counseled that the lumpectomy defect would be just too big.
Recovery time will vary depending on the amount of surgery, tissue that's removed, and the kind of technique that is needed to rebuild the breast, as well as patient factors like the size of the patient, the health of the patient, and the pain sensitivity. Because these are all variable, it's really hard to predict exactly how long it'll take until the patient feels like they have recovered from this operation. On average, I would see patients feeling more or less recovered and feel like their normal self in about 3 weeks or so. So that would be the average.
Thinking about appearance after surgery, I would say that it is always important for each individual patient to ask the surgeon team that they are working with what that surgeon team thinks they can expect, because everybody is individual and we need to think about every patient individually in terms of our surgical plan and in terms of what we expect for the surgical outcomes. So I think it's very hard to say that any one outcome could be expected in terms of shape, size, appearance, position, match between the sides. But I think that we all recognize that those are very important questions and very important endpoints for our patients. So a patient who has a larger breast that has a little bit more droop may expect that the breast could be smaller, elevated, a little bit rejuvenated. A patient who may have a smaller, higher breast to start with may expect a different shape, but maybe not as much of a lift or as much of a size change. And we really focus very hard on trying to predict as best we can what outcomes we can expect. But I do have to say that surgery is always a little bit unpredictable. So one of the main points that we need to be prepared for when we're going into a surgery is that we don't know exactly what the appearance will be or the size or the shape afterwards.
Breast reconstruction that is done as part of breast cancer treatment is covered by insurance. And because oncoplastic surgery is part of cancer treatment, it is covered by insurance.